Hi, I'm John Cash. Welcome to John Cash Ministries and Revelations Church's Daily Devotion. Today we're going to be in Colossians chapter 2, verses 6 through 8. I want to talk about Thanksgiving. With Thanksgiving coming up, or if you're watching this video a few days afterward or late, you'll know that we went through the Thanksgiving season. What does God want from us on Thanksgiving? What's the history of the holiday? First of all, understand the history of the holiday is very different than what it's turned out to be. Today in America, the holiday means turkey, it means football, it means gorging yourself, and it means having time with family and friends. But how much thankfulness is going on during Thanksgiving? That's what the holiday is all about. The pilgrims, when they came over, they had their first holiday Thanksgiving feast. They were thanking God they had food. They were thanking God they had a land where they were free to worship Him. It was all about Thanksgiving, and everything has changed. Now, I want you to understand that God wants us to have a thankful heart, and a thankful heart will lead to a happy heart. Take a look at verse 6. It says this, Colossians 2:6. So then, just as you receive Christ, Jesus as Lord, so He's speaking to Christians here, watch this, continue to live in Him. Continue to live in Him. See, the implication is that we can become Christian and then just go the way of the world. Verse 7 says we need to be rooted and built up in Him. See, the way that we continue as a Christian is to be rooted and built up in Him. We need our spiritual roots to go deep into Jesus Christ. The only way that happens, the only way that we become thankful because of that, is to be reading the Word daily, praying to God, having that personal commitment, that personal relationship with Jesus Christ. So He's saying to us, we need to continue to live in Him, recognize this is a living, breathing, active relationship. We need to stay rooted, and the roots need to go deeper and deeper and deeper. So you need to have those yourself fertilized and watered spiritually as you draw closer to God. As your roots grow deeper, you are built up higher and higher in Him. As that happens, the Bible says that you are strengthened in the faith. As you become stronger as a Christian, you will become more thankful for God's blessings. You'll become more thankful for God, what He did for you on the cross. You'll become more thankful for what God has done for you here on earth, walking with you. And you'll become more thankful for what He's going to do for you in heaven, eternity with Him. That's an amazing thought. So built up, rooted, strengthened in the faith, as you were taught. You got to be taught all this stuff. It takes time. And then notice at the end it says, and overflowing with thankfulness. We cannot be overflowing with thankfulness if we're not rooted, built up, and strengthened and being taught in the process. So thankfulness, a thankful heart, occurs when we draw closer and closer to God. Now, interesting in verse 8, we see the opposite of thankfulness. He says, see to it that no one takes you captive through hollow and deceptive philosophy, which depends on human tradition and the basic principles of this world rather than on Christ. Now, folks, today in America, there is a spirit, a human tradition. It is fiscal in nature. It is spiritual in nature. And it is political in nature. It is the me generation, the selfish generation, the entitlement generation. I'm entitled to this. Give me, give me, give me. Now, I don't want to get into the politics of that, but it is a political movement. It is the exact opposite of a thankful spirit. Now, you can get help from people or the government and be thankful, and that's fine, okay? But the spirit of the me generation, the entitlement generation, is not thankfulness. I deserve this. That's the opposite of thankfulness. And so this is why in verse 8, he says, look, this is how you should be thankful. The reasoning's why, but be careful that someone doesn't take you captive by the other philosophy. There are millions of Americans, and some of them in the church, that are being held hostage, captive, by this hollow and deceptive thinking. It doesn't lead to a thankful heart. What it does, it leads to spiritual moral, fiscal slavery. And so as we go through the Thanksgiving season, understand God doesn't want us to think we're entitled to anything. He wants us to be thankful for what we do have, even if it's not a lot, because He has provided it. God bless you, and happy Thanksgiving.